In this video, we'll show how to convert a project from one series of Productivity PLCs to another. The Productivity family of PLCs has three different platforms. There's the Productivity 3000, the Productivity 2000, and now the Productivity 1000. There are various reasons why you'd select one platform over another. Two of the main reasons, though, will be I/O count and price point. This is one of the things that makes this family of PLCs so versatile. You could take a project created for a large-scale installation and then convert that to a smaller setup, or vice versa. This allows you to reuse portions of your ladder code and not have to burn hours having to recreate the process. Now I'm going to continue on to show the basic process of converting a project, and in this example I will convert a project from a Productivity 2000 system to a Productivity 1000 system. So to begin the process, let's open up the Productivity software and the project you want to convert. Now, before you begin and make any alterations, I would strongly advise that you select Save As and make a fresh copy of this project, just to make sure that the original does not get altered accidentally. In this project, I have multiple tasks, all of which will be converted in this process. Also, if I go into the hardware configuration, you can see that I have multiple setups. I can see that the CPU's Ethernet port is set up. I have the web server set up. And I even have a few Ethernet IP clients set up. Now, all these things will be converted in this process. Now, to begin the conversion process, be right here in the hardware configuration and then select this button. Since this is a P2000 project, you have the option to either convert to a P3000 or a P1000 series. I'm going to select the P1000 project conversion. Now, once I select that, you'll see this dialog. Now, for this example, everything is fairly straightforward other than the analog modules. The previous modules used in the P2000 system were of an 8-point type, and in the P1000, they are a 4-point type. If I needed to keep all this analog I/O, I can right-click on the original modules and then select Split Original Module. As you can see, this takes the original 8-point modules and splits them across two 4-point modules each. But as I'm not using all 8 points, I will go back to the 4-point modules by selecting Restore. The good thing is I can see that none of these tags are actually used, as this column is not checked. And if you look at this column, this gives you the option to delete the extra 4 tags on each module. But since I have plenty of memory left over and this is a small project, I'm going to go ahead and select to keep them. So I'm going to press OK. As soon as I do so, I can see that all of my hardware is switched over to the P1000 series. Now, if I look closer at the CPU, I can see that the Ethernet setup for my CPU is still there. My remote access is still set up. And all of my Ethernet IP clients are still there. Now, if I go in and look at my ladder code, I can see that all of my tasks converted over. One final check. Let's compile our project to verify. Press F8, and I got an error message. Looks like I was using an LCD instruction. And since my P1000 does not have a display on the CPU, this instruction will not work. Go ahead and hit this locate button, and it'll take you to the point of the error in your ladder code. Now I can see here that the only instruction in this task was this LCD instruction. Now I can delete the task or the instruction, or I could just take the whole task and move it down to the disabled task bin. Now go ahead and save your project as a new project, and then you can go ahead and send it to your PLC. In just a few minutes, we've taken all of your hard work and was able to convert it to your new PLC effortlessly. I hope you found this video helpful, and if you have any more questions, please feel free to comment below or call into our award-winning support team. Click on this video to see more of our many support options. Click on this link to see our many products and solutions, and if you've liked what you saw here, please click here to subscribe to our YouTube channel for upcoming solutions. And thanks again.